Hi guys from Barbara and welcome to my ketogenic channel. As you can see, I'm still in Japan, still in Tokyo, but I moved to Shibuya, that is a very fun place. So after the recipe, I will bring you with me in a walk in this, come si dice quartiere? In this special neighborhood. Sorry for my English. But first, we are going to cook a cake that I've seen here. And I couldn't taste it because it was full of sugar, but I did the ketogenic version of that cake. That is exactly the same. I just changed the sweetener. So let's go together to my kitchen to prepare the cake. And after, let's go together to walk in Shibuya. These are the few ingredients that we are going to use: 5 eggs, 4 tablespoons of powdered erythritol, vanilla seeds, but you can also use the flavor or the essence. And then for the cooking, some butter. The first step is to separate the 5 yolks from the 5 whites. I will not show you this because I'm a disaster doing that, but I succeed this time, and here you can see they are separated. The step 2 that you are already watching on video is to whip the whites very firmly. You should be able to turn this ball upside down without the whites falling out, but be careful, please. Just before finishing this job, we will add 2 teaspoons of powdered erythritol to the whites and 2 teaspoons of powdered erythritol to the yolks. Then you can add also the vanilla seeds to this mix. This is a special moment because you could also personalize this cake, maybe with cinnamon, with cardamom, or also with lemon zest or lemon juice. So you can choose your favorite flavor. I choose vanilla. I would like to remind you that if you don't have powdered erythritol, you can blend it, the granulated one, and it will become powdered. If you don't have erythritol at all, you can choose another sweetener, your favorite one, but please check that it should have 0 calories. If it has 0 calories, it's always ketogenic. Talking about the erythritol, I would like to remind you that usually they write there is 100% carbohydrates, but having 0 calories, it means that our body is not able to use those carbohydrates, so it's not a problem. Don't worry at all. Erythritol with 0 calories is always ketogenic, like all the sweeteners with 0 calories. After whipping the whites with the sweetener, it's now time to whip the yolks with the sweetener and the vanilla. And all our ingredients will be ready for the cooking. You know, I'm not a big lover of unsticky pans, but for this recipe is 100% necessary. So just warm up a little piece of butter, and when it's completely melted, it's time to put the yolks. This looks like a crepe, and it could definitely become a keto crepe. So if you want to do just a simple crepe, use this recipe and turn this little frittata to the other side, because crepe is cooked
both sides, but for this cake we only need to cook it on the bottom part, so it's super easy. We just have to leave it at medium heat during 1 minute. Then it's time to add the whites. As you can see, I'm trying to shape it like a cake. The whites should be of the same height all over the pan. After doing that, we should put the heat at medium-low, cover with a lid and leave our cake, our whites, cooking during 5 minutes. So 1 minute, the bottom part, plus 5 minutes with the whites. And it's almost ready. You should only put it on a plate and if you prepare 2 cakes, it will be round. I only do one because it's more than enough for us. We are 4 and we will prepare 4 slices. Cut it in half and close this cake like they do in Japan. It will look amazing because it's a very high cake, but it's very soft. You can also eat it by hands, holding it with your hands, and it's super fun. As you can imagine, this cake has a strong eggy flavor. So if you don't like egg, it's not for you. But if you love eggs like me, it's perfect. I highly recommend, if you don't like egg, to use the lemon zest, the lemon flavor, the lemon juice that will take out a little bit of eggy flavor. Or if you put the vanilla like me, you could also put the flavor or the essence that is stronger if you don't want to feel that egg so much. And I also would like to tell you that we had a slice on the following day, and the first day it's very soft, but if you leave it outside on the countertop on the following day, it will be a little bit crunchy. And I can tell you that I prefer it on the following day, but it depends on your taste, on what you like. So that's super easy to prepare, it's super fun, and it's super Japanese. Please let me know if you prepare this cake, if you like it, if you have any idea to make a different version of this cake, and please send me the picture on my Instagram account. I'm always very happy to receive the pictures of your dishes prepared with my recipe, and I thank all the people that are sending me pictures.
Hope you like today's recipe and you will consider subscribing to my channel. So we will meet here every Monday at 2 o'clock Italian time with another ketogenic video in English, but also on Wednesday at the same time with the same video in Spanish, and on Friday in Italian. See you next week, and thank you all for subscribing, liking and leaving me nice comments down below. I'm a little bit late answering the comments because the telephone. Bye.
And as I promise you, here we are in Shibuya, and we are so lucky because it's the Sakura. The Sakura is the Japanese season when the cherry blossoms are on the trees, and it's incredibly beautiful. Shibuya is a very trendy, colorful and happy place. I love it. You can see Japanese cartoon everywhere and a lot of young people. Here there is the Shibuya Crossing. That is famous to be the busiest crosswalk in the world. I had to admit that I crossed the street several times because I'm not good in taking the videos while walking and while all these people are around me. It was complicated and a lot of fun. I hope you enjoyed our walk together, and I'm looking forward to being here with you next week with another video from Japan.